In this video, in this ongoing series, I'm going to have a look at another scenic item. Now, what we're wanting to do today is to add some kind of a security fencing around this line side mobile mast and REB hut. So we're going to have, with the fence running here, a gate on this side, the fence running around the back, and the fence on this side here. We're not obviously going to put anything across here because the sort of little yard for this area here is modelled off stage. So we're going to choose one of these three kits to do the area that we're going to model today. Now the first one is the chain link security fencing with the just a wire top, comes with a set of gates. There's two versions of this. There's the cranked post top and the straight post top. I'll put links down below for this one. The next one is this palisade security fencing kit, and this one is a more detailed one with the posts being much more 3D. I'll show you a section of that on the layout in a minute. Or there's this one, which is, it's a slightly easier to build version. It's very quick to do, and you can soon have that on your layout. So as you can see here in front of you, this is the easier to build version, and that's the LX055-00 kit. And if you notice on the left side here, we've added some litter from one of the texture wrap sheets with like a plastic bag stuck on top of the fence, newspaper stuck on the low part of the fence there, and there's various bits of litter. So that's the easy to build fence. I've actually done a video on this previously, so I'll put a link in one of the cards on the right hand side of the screen here for you to have a look at that video if you're interested. The more detailed version, the LX0017-00 kit, as you can see, used on the back here. I'll post a picture now of a close-up shot so you can guys see. So out of the three kits, I think we're going to go for this one on the scene that we're going to be modelling today. So we'll now take a look at how the kit goes together. So with this particular kit, the LX0017-00, as you can see here, it builds up to 90 centimetres long section of fencing. It includes one pair of gates, four gate posts and 30 posts and 25 fence panels. So as per normal, you get four comprehensive instructions and also on how to mount them, install them on your baseboard, whether it being level, on a slope and the gates. As we've already used part of this on the layout with the bit you've just seen in the previous clip, so there's some bits that are missing off here. So you get two sheets, you get your fence panels, and these are held in by tiny pips, so it's just a case with the old craft knife, just gently going through and just removing the pips. You have your gate posts, the lock, so it's a mechanism to go on one of the gates. You get the upright posts, and on this sheet here you get the rest of the posts, because these actually build up into the proper H or I girder type that the panels mount onto. So you have your central piece and the two side pieces that slot on. As you can see here, these holes here, they slot onto the corresponding slots here, so it goes together very well. It's a very easy kit to put together. So we've cut out some of the components that we need, which is the panels, the girder pieces that run across here, and we've also pulled out a couple of the H girder uprights. So what we're going to have a look at is assembling sort of one panel with the posts either side. So as I've shown in a previous video on this series many times, is that we're using the Deluxe Materials Rokit car glue. Really good stuff this. And again, after using, if you just rinse some warm and cold water through the tube to stop the glue drying and setting in there, just flushes it out, so it's ready to use for next time. So having cut off the panel and two of the cross girder pieces, we're now going to run a wee bead of glue just along the edge like so, and then taking one of the upright pieces, it's handy if you've got a pair of tweezers, just helps for handling, is to then just line it up at either end and just place it on like so before the glue sets. Just fine tune it like so. Once you've done that, again another bead of glue, and again with the girder piece like so. Any excess glue, just wipe off with a cloth. So there you go, that is one of the panels. So these bits, if you when installing the layout, these from memory would face on the inside of the property with the outside not having the girder bits. So we now move on to the posts. And started with Peter, here's one we've done earlier. So you can see, I don't know if the camera will pick it out, the HI girder. And your three component parts, which is the central core with your slots and the two side pieces with your holes. Now one thing to note is that if you look carefully, that at the top end here the holes are closer together, and at the bottom here the wider part, so they'll only go on one way, so bear that in mind when assembling it. So again with the trusty glue, take the central piece and carefully slot it into the holes. Now it depends how good your eyesight is, some may find that a bit fiddly, some may not. So as you can see there, on one side of the girder piece. So again, we run another bead of glue and take the girder again and slot into the hole. Like so. And that is one I girder, H girder for the fence. So to assemble this together. So again, if you're looking at the slot holes, the two wider parts, these tally up and match up with the two cross girder pieces on your fence panel, and the two shorter ones, these are the bits that you'll be drilling a hole in your baseboard to insert. If you don't fancy drilling a hole, you can cut these short and just simply glue the fence to your layout. So it's now a case of where the holes are, splodge your glue and the one there, take your fence panel and just placing it over like so. So it's just now a case of holding this for about a minute or two while you get the glue chance to set. So now that's glued together, we just add another splodge of glue here and here, and again hold the fence panel in place while the glue sets. And as you can see here, this is the fence panel with the two posts completed. This is the gate, and we're now going to add a splodge of glue and add the locking mechanism, as you can see here. This is the locking mechanism, and just in case I'm now sticking it onto the pre-glued part. Like so. Here we're now going to add one of the uprights to the gate at both ends. So again, it's a case of just running a bead of glue along the end and sticking the uprights as shown. So as you can see here, we've cut this upright in half to allow it to fit either side of the gate locking mechanism. And again, in case of just running another bead of glue top and bottom of the locking mechanism and sticking the upright pieces on. So in this clip we're now gluing the top and bottom cross pieces and sticking the top and bottom cross girder pieces on like so. Here we're now just adding another bead of glue along the edge of the gate at both ends, and these are for the other uprights, and this is on the side of the gate which does not have the cross girder beams, so this is basically like the front of the gate or the outside of the gate. So on this clip here, we're now gluing the gate post together, and the one you can see here is the hinge one. And one to the left hand glue in here, you can see has the two hinge pieces on. And this will be the middle of the gate post. So the two other pieces, as you can see here, will sandwich the piece with the hinges on. So this is one side of the, basically the post sandwich. So we're now gluing the other side of the, technically what's the post sandwich, and now adding the two parts that have already been glued together onto the third part here to complete the hinged post. So we now turn our attention to the post at the locking mechanism side of the gate, and again, just as before, we're making like a post sandwich where it's three pieces glued together in a stack to create the post. We're now going to glue the hinged post onto the gate, so it's gluing the two hinges as you can see here and attaching it to the gate side with the two hinges that you can see here. And once we've done this, it's just a case of gluing the other side of the gate post to their end. So in the last clip, as you saw with the gate, we've now added on the other post at their end, and we've now glued it onto the rest of the fence. You're actually looking at the fence here, it's upside down. I just sort of sit nice and level here for you guys with the camera. So the taller bits that you see sticking, these are the bits that you'll stick into the holes that we're going to drill next for the fence to sit into. One thing I need to point out to you guys, I forgot to mention, was with these panels, is that you've got the more pointed end, which is slightly taller from the bar, sticking up to that end. As you can see, bottom end, that's flat. So make sure you get these in the right way around, the pointed end obviously to the top. For painting, I'm just going to use this cheap grey acrylic spray paint. So take too long to paint up and it dries pretty quickly. And then it's just a case of adding some weathering to suit. So we're going to paint this up now, and then we're going to have a look with it going on to the layout. So as you can see, we've now drilled our holes using a 2mm drill bit, various points around this site here, and we're now going to use some super glue like this, a dab in each hole, and that's just a case of inserting the posts into the hole. So as you can see now, the fence has been inserted into the holes and glued in place, and we've added some bushes, foliage, stuff to blend it in. The fence has also been given a slight bit of weathering as well. So the next thing I'm thinking of now adding, that I've got in my bits box, is this roll of 00 gauge barbed wire, and it's from a model company called Javis. And the part number you want to look for is reference JBARB, J-Barb. So as you can now see, the barbed wire is now being glued on. We've done it in two sections, short bit across the top of the gate, and then the rest of it running around along the top of the fence. We've added some safety signage on the gate there, and a plastic carrier bag from some supermarket that somebody's dropped, and the wind has blown and it's got trapped under the fence there. In the compound, we've done a couple of short sections of barbed wire that the engineers have left after doing a repair job to replace some barbed wire on top of the fence. And on the coil on the left hand side, you can just see to the right of it is an old newspaper that's been dropped. So that concludes this part of this model railway series video. In the next video we'll possibly look at doing a layout update, with plenty more stuff to follow. Thanks for watching.